हाँ
सर।
सर, यस सर।
ओके
विलेन
सुष्मिता,
ऑफ कॉमेडी एंड ब्रशेस।
सुष्मिता आर यू देयर? हाँ,
यस सर।
इट वाज योर वॉइस ओनली, आई कैन रिकॉग्नाइज। सो डिजाइन ऑफ कम्यूटेटर एंड ब्रश। नाउ बेसिकली दिस कम्यूटेटर एंड ब्रश, हाउ वी डिजाइन, एंड दिस इज द ऑन टॉप यू कैन सी दिस इज द ब्रश। सो दिस इज द विड्थ ऑफ द ब्रश, विड्थ, एंड दिस इज द लेंथ ऑफ द ब्रश। And there are three things: length, width, and thickness of the brush. And this is the leaving edge from where the brush will leave, and this is the entering edge. And this brush is put mounted on top of the commutator. So if you can see, the commutator has got segments like this. In the lab, I can show you. I will take some pictures in the lab if it is available. Commutator brush, if it is in open condition, then only we can do. Okay, then it will be very clear to you. So, what are the important factors that are considered in the design for the commutator? So, number one thing is that how commutator is designed. So, what are the material that is required for the design of the commutator? Essentially, if you see that the commutator is constructed by using hard-drawn copper, and it is separated in between themselves by mica, thin sheets of mica. And you can see the number of commutator segments. Now, the number of commutator segments would depend upon the number of coils in the field winding, okay? And the number of coils or segment would be one half of the armature slots, one half of the armature slots. So this 4 is equal to, see this one half of these slots. See this one half USA I have written. So what is this U? And SA is armature slots. What is this U? U is coil sides per slot. How many coil sides we are using per slot? It will definitely vary from 2, 4, 6, and 8. Why not 1, 3, 5, and 7? You tell me, anybody can tell? Why 2, 4, 6, and 8? Why it's an even number? Why it's not an odd number? Usually the poles will not be. Have you heard about single pole machine or three pole machine? No, no. It is always a pair of poles. So the minimum pair will form by two. So hence it's always an even number, not an odd number. So the minimum number of coils or segments is obtained when voltage between commutator segments is 15 volts. So what does that mean? The minimum number of coil segments is obtained. Means only if you are exciting less than 15 volts, your machine will not get excited at no load. So you need at least minimum 15 volts such that your coil section gets established. So minimum number of coils or segments for a machine has to be your induced EMF EP. That is, E is induced EMF, E into the number of poles divided by 15. So, for example, you have in a problem, four pole machine, 440 volts. What are the minimum number of coil segments? So, you have to do 440 into number of poles, for example, 2, 440 into 2, 880 divided by 15. And a problem if it comes like that. So, this is the ratio. Why this 15 is the ratio? DC machine has got critical field resistance. If you have studied, it has got a critical field resistance. DC machine, sometimes what happens after a long time, you are exciting a machine, it does not start only. But then you find it that you separately excited because field winding loses magnetism. And now you have to magnetize it again such that it picks up the speed. Or else you have to interchange this positive and negative, or you have to separately excite it. And the minimum number of separately excited such that it picks up is 15 volts. So, and for this 15 volts, minimum number of coil segments would be like this. So, commutator diameter. Now, you have seen this is the commutator, this is the brush put over top of it. Now, the commutator dia. So, the diameter of the commutator is taken around 0.6 to 0.8 D. D is what? D is the main dimension diameter, where D is the armature diameter. Okay, so D, in case of a DC machine, D is armature dia, L is armature length. So commutator diameter happens to be, it depends upon the size of the machine, what type of the machine you are using. For example, for a 300 to 700 volt, it would be around 0.62D. As far as your 200 to 250 is concerned, it would be 0.68D. And as far as your 100 to 125 volt is concerned, it would be around 0.75D. So the peripheral speed of the commutator should be between peripheral speed. Shushmita, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Now you tell me, peripheral speed of the commutator, how do you express peripheral speed in terms of your diameter and speed? Yesterday we have studied peripheral, one numerical also we have done. So how do we express, what is the formula for peripheral speed? Can you tell? Shushmita?
Anil, yes,
can you tell Shushmita what would be it? It is pi dn. It is? Repeat after me, Shushmita. It is?
Yes, sir.
It is pi dn. Peripheral speed is?
Pi dn.
So d stands for diameter of the armature. And n stands for speed in rotation per second. N stands for?
Speed of the rotation.
Speed of the rotation per second. So pi dn. So now no problem if you have not followed also. So it is very easy subject, electrical machine design. Some three, four formulas are there. And any which was, if they try to manipulate the problem also, you can do the problem because it is not Laplace transform. It is 10th class mathematics. So no need to worry. Okay. So you are having some apprehensions about machine design, any student? Huh? Is worrying whether we'll fail or like that. You should not think like that. It's very easy subject. I want 100% result. You will give me 100% result. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, you are confident? Huh?
Yes, sir.
How is the Josh?
Yes, sir.
Josh is good. Okay. So now you have to go for this. See, these are
by own effort we'll do.
Huh? Yeah, tell me.
Hi, Josh sir.
Josh sir, Josh.
What? Oh, Josh.
Full of Josh.
You have to have this because if you are not like if you are sleeping in the class, then you have to like wake up. Okay.
So in your class, you are not sleeping.
These things, these things happen only class, sir. Everyone get pass, sir.
This thing happens what? Pakresh, you tell me. In online class,
sir.
In online class, no Josh, sir.
No Josh, yeah?
Yes,
why?
Sir.
What is the problem with the online thing?
No network issue, sir.
Poor network, sir.
Okay. So.
We are on the terrace, sir.
Okay. You are enjoying my class or not?
Sir?
You are enjoying the class online or not?
Yeah, sir, but network issue.
Yeah, somebody, some girl wants to say, yeah, say something. Tell. Tara, is it?
Yes, sir.
You want to say something?
Sure. About online class, sir?
Yeah. What it's difficult?
It's good, sir, but it will not be that effective as we interact in class.
That is there. That is there. So that I also know. But what can we do? Corona is there. So we have to like, this is the other best possible alternative. It cannot replace the normal class because in that I can come to you, I can see what you are doing, whether you have understood or not. Here I cannot monitor you. I don't know whether you are like simply logged in and there you are watching some Netflix movie. I don't know that also. Okay.
Sir, so not data, sir.
So, thickness of segments is in case of the commutator peripheral speed, we'll go back to the class. So, the commutator peripheral speed we see is equal to what? Pi dc into n meter per second. We have seen this previously also. So where your DC is your commutator diameter and your N is your speed. So thickness of segment should be less than 3 millimeter, and the mica thickness should be around 0.8 millimeter. Minimum segment pitch is around, what is this pitch? Can you tell minimum segment pitch? Pitch would be mean what? Commutator segment pitch. Pitch would means in the entire length, how many number of coils you are placing. For example, you have 10 meter. In that 10 meter, one pitch would be one turn, like one coil pitch, one turn, or one conductor pitch like this. Yesterday, I have to show you. You can see like this, na, that turn. So, commutator segment pitch would be the length, that is pi DC, that is the circumference of the cross-sectional section, because circular section, that is 2 pi r, that is diameter of the commutator DC, that DC is points, how much it is? DC is around this 0.62D for 300, 0.68D for 200, and 0.75D for this. So DC, pi DC is the commutator diameter.
Yeah.
Thickness of segments is less than 3 millimeter, mica thickness is this. And a commutator segment pitch BC would be equal to pi DC by C. Okay. So DC is the diameter of the commutator and C is the number of the coils. Now for better design, if you have to design better design, your beta C, that is your commutator segment pitch, should be not more than 4 millimeter. And your length of the commutator is decided by space required for the brush. Length of the commutator is decided by space required for the brush, surface area to dissipate the heat generated by the losses in the commutator. So you require the space by the brush and the surface area required to the heat generated by losses in the commutator. So length of the commutator, how do you give the length of the commutator? Now this is the commutator, okay, on top. This is the commutator segments, and now how do you go about the length of the commutator? You can see the length of the commutator, can brush width also comes in there. Then this part is also there. This part is also there. So how do you go about the length of the commutator? So length of the commutator is decided by what? Length of the commutator, we can write NB, WB plus CB plus C1 plus C2. So NB is what? Number of brushes per spindle. Spindle means per arrangement. And WB is the width of each brush, that we saw width of each brush will play. And CB is clearance between brushes, because there won't be one brush. There won't be one brush. For example, for a four-pole machine, there would be around 8 brushes mounted. So there is some clearance also between the brushes. It cannot, otherwise it will short circuit. So that width you have to take, clearance you have to take, okay. So now it is the length of the brush. How do we identify? The length of the commutator is given by NB, that is the number of brushes per spindle, and WB is width of each brush, your CB is clearance between the brush, and your C1 and C2, what is this? C1 is clearance allowed for staggering the brushes. So C1 is 10 millimeter for smaller machines and 30 millimeter for large machines. C2 is clearance for the end play. So here you can see if you go back, so there you can see this is leaving edge. So here some clearance would be there, entering edge. So C1 is basically for the entering edge and C2 is basically for the leaving edge. So again, we'll go back here. So this is the C2 clearance for allowing the end play. So this C1 happens to be around 10 millimeter for small machines, whereas 30 millimeter for large machines. Similarly, C2 value is around 10 to 25 millimeter, depending upon the size of the machine. For small machine, it is 10, and for large machines, it is 25 millimeter. So LC is what? LC is essentially the length of the commutator segment. So LC, if LC is less, if your length of the commutator section is less, so in less length, your current flow would be less, because and cross-sectional surface will decrease, and your I square R will decrease, because if for less length, there would be less heat dissipated in form of loss. So heat dissipation is less. So So if heat is less, temperature rise would what happen? Temperature rise see, will decrease. He has written increase. And this exceeds, now if the heat dissipation, if your LC is less, heat dissipation is less. And this heat dissipation, what it does is, it controls the temperature. Suppose if heat dissipation is less, temperature rise would be less, and it will not lead the circuit to exceed the permissive limit. For example, if the heat dissipation was more, then temperature rise would be more, and it will lead to exceed the permissible limit of the brush. Now there are losses in the commutator. Now what are the losses in the commutator? There are two losses in the commutator. One is the brush contact loss, and another is the brush friction loss. So here you can see the brush is contacting with the commutator. Straight, this contact is causing loss, that is called brush contact loss. And in between, when commutator is moving, it is rotating, there is amount of friction that is in, coming into play, and this is called as friction loss. So there are two losses in the commutator. One is your brush contact loss, another is your brush friction loss. As far as your brush contact loss is concerned, so yesterday also I have told you, your brush current or your is two times your this thing. So power in the brush contact loss would be voltage drop per brush set into current per brush. So voltage drop per brush set would be 2, and current per brush would be IB, because for one set it would be 2. So this happens to be P is equal to 2 times IB. Now, what is the power that would be developed due to the friction? That will be given by this formula, that is mu naught PB, PAB, VC, wherein mu naught is coefficient of friction. Usually it lies between around 0.1 to 0.3, and your PB is the brush contact pressure. PB is the brush contact pressure, and your P is the number of poles. AB is effective area of all brushes. Okay. And what is your VC? Can anybody tell what is the VC? VC is basically the coefficient of friction. And your commutator temperature, theta C, it depends upon your PC into C into SC. Where your C here is called the cooling coefficient. PC is called the total commutator loss. And your SC is pi DC LC. So pi DC LC, what is that? Surface area of heat dissipation. And your VC is the peripheral speed of commutator dissipation in meter per second. So this is the empirical formula which they have developed over the years when they are practicing with the machines, and they have governed which are the factors that are making it to responsible. So this temperature rise depends upon essentially your total commutator loss, that is your power loss in the commutator PC. Then again the cooling coefficient. The cooling coefficient is determined by a formula, 120 in loss in watts per centimeter square divided by 1 plus 0.1 VC. So this is essential. Apart from that, your SC is your surface area of heat dissipation. So that is again given by a formula, pi DC LC. And your VC is peripheral speed of commutator dissipation, that is given in meter per second. So how do you go for the design of brush? So tell me, Fakresh, you have done diploma, right? Fakresh, are you there? Fakresh? Fakresh? Very well. Fakresh Naik? Anil Kumar AB? Harish? Jeevan?
Sir, Anil, sir.
Anil, where is this Fakresh?
Sir, some network is, sir.
Nivedita? Nivedita?
Yes, sir.
You are there? Yeah, tell me, you have done diploma?
Yes, sir.
So you tell me, in diploma, you are being taught about DC machines. In that, you have been taught about the brushes. From which material brushes are made, you know?
Carbon, sir, carbon.
No, I am asking to Nivedita, I am not asking to you. Okay. Now I will ask to you, who said carbon? Who is telling carbon? Now, why they are made of carbon? Tell me, Pagresh.
Soft material, sir.
Soft material, okay. Why we are considering soft material? Reason? Why not hard material?
To
cannot
avoid the spark. To avoid the spark and the wear and tear, sir.
To avoid the spark and wear and tear. Apart from that, any reason?
Carbon, sir.
Huh? What, Anil Kumar, you are telling something?
Easy to catch current, sir.
Easy to catch current means. So, design of brush is material.
High resistance, sir.
High resistance means current, how it will catch easily. See, that is your...
Yeah.
See, now mute this, I will explain you. In your home, you have noticed what we will do when making the home. They will put some salt and charcoal while making a new home. Reduce the resistance. If the resistance is less, resistance is less, what will happen? Current will flow to the path. Easy to flow, not by increasing the resistance. Clear your concept. So material used is carbon, carbon graphite and metal graphite. So the dimensions of the brush depend upon, obviously you have seen the dimensions of the brush. The dimensions of the brush depend upon what? Dimensions of the brush depend upon the length. You can see the length and the this width of the brush is length, width, apart from that thickness of the brush. So this is on the topic, the dimension of the brushes will depend upon. And now you have seen the temperature rise also. It depends upon your PC, whereas PC is total commutator loss. C is your cooling coefficient. Your SC is pi d CLC, surface area of heat dissipation. VC is peripheral speed of the commutator dissipation, that is given in meter per second. So the design of brush is dependent upon this. So the thickness of the brush selected is such that it covers 2 to 3 commutator segments, the thickness of the brush. So the number of brush is decided by the type of winding. Now the type of winding, whether you are using lap winding, wave winding. So the number of brushes for case of lap winding, it would be equal to the number of poles, and in wave winding, it would be always equal to the 2. Okay, in wave, because your number of parallel paths is always, for an 8-pole wave wound machine, it would be always 2. But for an 8-pole lap wound machine, it would be always 6. Now I'll ask some questions. Wait. G1M. G1M. G1. Not there. I'm marking him absent. Mohammad Rafiq. G1M. Pradeep. Pradeep. Nivedita.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you answer me. See, these people I'm marking. G1M is absent. G1M is absent today. Mohammad Rafiq is also absent. I don't care. Mohammad Rafiq is also absent. Your Harish is also absent. Harish R.
Sir, I'm there, sir.
You are there, okay, very good. Harish is there. Sachin Reddy. Sachin Reddy is also absent. Sachin Reddy. Sachin Reddy. Sagar S. Sagar S is also. Samir Singh is absent. Sagar S. Samir Singh. Samir Singh. Shashankar. Shashankar also. Where is Shashankar? Shashankar. What you will say, Prashant? Absent. Shashankar is also absent. I'm seeing, I have opened this. Shilpa.
Present, sir.
You are there. So, yeah, Shilpa, tell me the number of brushes for a wave wound 8-pole machine, that is wave wound, how many number of brushes will be there for an 8-pole machine? That is wave wound. Tell me.
2, sir.
No. How you are telling 2? For an 8-pole machine, Shilpa, you tell me. For an 8-pole wave wound machine, how many number of brushes would be there? Shilpa? Shilpa, yes?
2, sir. 2.
How? Why not 8? Shilpa, yeah, keep your mic open. I'm talking to you. Tell me why not 8? Shilpa? Why eight? Why not two? What is the reason? What is the reason? Tell me. Don't read in the chat and all that thing. Tell me what is the reason. The reason is that it is wave bound. In a wave bound machine, there would be always two number of parallel paths.
Yeah, sir. A equals to two.
Okay. And the number of brushes will be equal to two. Pradeep Kumar, yeah, tell me. Manohar Reddy. See, you are playing around with your life like this. None of you are there. I can see that. Manishri. Viramani, your mic is okay. We'll put in chat. Let's see what happened to you. Your mic. Viramani. Yeah, in chat you put. Are you there, Viramani? Viramani.
He's there, sir. He's chatting.
He's chatting, huh? Where is chatting?
Send your message only.
Yeah, I'm there. Okay, very good. See, you are there, you're a good person. That's what I was wondering. What has happened to you people? Not present, Manohar Reddy is there. See, you get your mics and everything okay, because it has to be interactive. Like this, if I do, means I'm presenting to myself only. So until and unless you will not interact, you will not learn. So the thickness of the brush selected is such that it covers 2 to 3 commutator segments. So number of brushes you use is decided by the type of winding. Now, for example, if you have a lap winding, the number of brushes would be equal to the number of poles. In case of wave winding, the number of brushes would be always equal to 2. So, will be always equal to 2. Wait, one second. Hello?
Online.
Hello? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So area of each brush, see what happens is that area of each brush should be able to carry not more than 70 ampere. So we can use the relation between current and area by means of current density. So current density, what it is? Current density is current divided by, tell me anyone? Current and for
Krish, area, sir.
Current divided by area. Very good. So now you know that as far as your current carried by each brush spindle is. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, voice is breaking.
Voice is breaking. Okay. Now it will not break. So current divided by each brush spindle, IB would be 2 times IA/P. That we have seen also. Okay. Now total brush contact area per spindle would be IB by this delta B. So this would be 2IA/P into SB. So this current density. So IA is what?
Delta.
Delta B, yes. IA is what? Armature current. Delta B is current density in the brush. NB is equal to number of brushes per spindle. And WB is width of each brush. Okay. And TB is thickness of each brush. So now contact area of each brush, now area for the each brush, if you go to this area of the each brush would depend upon, see area would depend upon your this area width into thickness. So it would be dB into TB. So area of width. So area of, now contact area, contact where it is contacting. Contacting what? Contacting the commutator segment. So for that contact area of each brush, AB would be equal to width of each brush into thickness of each brush. So total contact area of the spindle AB is given as number of brushes per spindle. AB total contact area is NB. Means it won't, no, not only one brush would be there. There would be many brushes and they will have this of same dimension. So it would depend upon the number of brushes into AB. So in other terms, you can write AB is equal to NB. Instead of AB, you can write width of the brush and thickness of the brush. So AB would be NB, WB into TB. And AB, you have already seen AB is equal to 2IAP and LB. So this 2IAP and LB you can substitute instead of AB. So you get 2IAP del B is equal to NB WB TB. So this current density del B here lies between 6 to 15 ampere per centimeter square. You have to see this per centimeter square. Now if you have to express this in terms of meter, if it is in centimeter square, then you have to multiply 10 power 4. Now if it was millimeter square, then 10 power 6. So in the numerical you have to be a little bit careful if some numerical comes like that. And del B depends on the type of the material. Current density, your current divided by area would obviously depend upon the type of the material which you are using. And width of the brush, if you have to calculate width of the brush, that is AB NB by TB, or in other terms, C. AB by NB is what? AB by NB is small AB, isn't it? AB by NB is small AB. Small AB is area of one brush. Capital AB is area of all the brushes. So AB by NB is small AB. So you width of the brush you will get in terms of this thing, AB by NB you will replace by small AB, and this is TB. So WB is equal to AB by TB. And similarly, the number of brushes per spindle, NB. Now NB you can write number of brushes, NB would be AB by AB. So capital AB by small AB. So let's see one problem based upon this. How can we establish one problem based upon this? Let's wind up the class. So I'll be opening the problem. So design of commutator. So we have one problem here. Numerical. Yeah. Can you see the numerical? Can you see?
No, sir.
Oh, so I need to present it. Wait. Yeah. I'm not presenting it. Wait. Stop presenting. Present now. Chrome tab. Now you can see the numerical.
No, sir.
Determine okay.
Yes, sir. No.
Okay. Yeah. You can see or not?
Sir, it's blurred
the diameter.
Yes, sir. We can see.
That's what I'm telling. Determine the diameter length of armature core for a 55 kilowatt, 110 volt, 1000 RPM, 4-pole shunt generator. Assuming the specific electric and magnetic loadings as electric loading is that AC. In some books, it is given as Q, so don't get confused. That is 26,000 ampere conductors per meter. Now you see the dimensions. Keep track of these dimensions accordingly if you have to modify. And 0.5 Weber per meter square, no problem. Everything is now in meters, respectively. The pole arc should be about 70% of pole pitch. Means pole arc L by Z ratio, it is telling 70%. 70% would mean 70 divided by 100. That would mean L by Z is equal to 0.7. And length of the core about 1.1 times the pole arc. So pi d by p, that is equal to 1.1 times the pole arc. Allow 10 ampere for the fixed current. And assume a voltage drop of 4 volt for the armature circuit. So voltage drop of 4 volt for the armature circuit. Specify the winding used, means whether you are going for a lap or a wave winding. And also determine the suitable values for the number of armature conductors. That would be armature conductors and number of slots. So how do you go? First, given data you have to write. Given data, power of the machine is 55 kilowatt. Voltage of the machine is 110 volt, speed is 1000 RPM, your number of pole is 4, ampere conductor happens to be 26,000 ampere conductors per meter, your average flux, magnetic flux density is 0.5 Weber per meter square, your L by Z or B by tau ratio is 70%, that happens to be 0.7, your L value is 1.1 times your B value, okay, here, or 1.1 times your D value, whatever you are taken. Your field current, it's given 10 ampere, and your voltage drop in the armature, that is armature current into a resistance of 4 volt. So now what you require to find? So first of all, is asking to find the D and L. Then tell me the type of winding, wave winding, lap winding. Third thing is number of armature conductors, that is Z. So if you find two T phase, you can find Z. Now Z would be twice T phase. So number of turns, if you find, you are able to find this. And then number of slots. Now, whenever we are doing such kind of problem, so what current we don't have? We don't have the load current. Now, in case of a generator, your armature is equal to I load plus I field. Suppose it was a motor, in that case, your I load is equal to I armature plus I field. So first of all, we'll write the simple equation. PA is equal to C naught D square LN. Now LN is in RPS. If it was in terms of RPM, then 1.64 in 10 power minus 4, that factor will come. But now is considering like this. So PA value would be, what is power? Power would be E IA in 10 power minus 3 kW. Now your generated EMF, it's a generator. In a generator, your EMF is always greater than your terminal voltage. So generated EMF would be terminal voltage plus drop. So terminal voltage, it is given terminal voltage is 110 volts and drop is 4 volts. So generated voltage is this plus this. So it would be 114. So 114 volt. Again, now you have your I armature, that is given. I armature 10, I field is given 10 amperes. Now, if you want to calculate your I armature or I load, how do you calculate I armature or I load? So essentially, you can write your I armature is equal to IL plus IF. IF value is given. IL you can calculate. How you can calculate? You can equate your power. P is equal to V into IL in 10 power minus 3. P value given 110. IL value you can get from here. So IL value you get 500 amperes. So this is 500 amperes plus 10. Because your field value given. So IA value is 510 amperes. Now you got this value of 510. Now the thing is that, now what is the output power of the motor? Output power of the motor is EMF in the motor. That EMF is 114. Okay, same question. That EMF would be 114 plus IA you calculated. IA is 510 into 10 power minus 3. So your output power is 114. Into 510 in 10 power minus 3, this is 58.14. Suppose if efficiency was given, no need to do all this. Directly PA by efficiency, you will get the value. But now since like this, the question is framed, so you will do like this only. Now the value of C naught, you can calculate B pi square BAV AC into 10 power minus 3. BAV value 0.5 given, AC value given, ampere 26,000. Here some water has fallen, that's why it got rubbed. And your N value you have to express in terms of N by 60, so 16.667 RPS, because that value is given in terms of RPM. So either you will do that factor 1.64, or if you are writing the same formula, then you have to divide this by 60. So once you are dividing 1000 by 60, you are getting 16.67, and then you will substitute here. So once you are substituting here, C naught value you calculated, N value you know, PA value calculated, you get the value of D square L. Now what is given? Given is L is equal to 1.1 times this D. So and again L by Z ratio is 0.7. So B is 0.7 T. 0.7 T means what? This is L by Z ratio. So L is equal to 0.7 Z L or B by tau. Usually we are using this as L by Z. So Z value is pi D by P. Okay, so here tau value would be pi D by P. So, and one more formula he has given, L is equal to 1.1 times of Z. So 1.1 times of Z. Z is what? 0.7 this thing. So this 0.7 pi D by P and L 1.1. So you get L in terms of 0.6047D. So 0.6047D substitute here. Instead of D, so this D cube, so you'll get the value of D. Once you get the value of T, substitute back, you get the value of L. So the first problem you have solved, main dimensions are available. First tick mark, main dimensions d and n value are done. Now we have to go to find out the type of winding it is, whether it is a lap winding or a wave winding. Now let's see, let's suppose it's a wave winding. So current per phase per parallel path would be IA by 2. So IA you calculated 510. So 510 by 2 happens to be 215 amperes. Whereas for lap winding, current per parallel path would be 510 by 4, 127.5. And current per brush arm would be 225 ampere. So we already know in the previous section what is the range of the current for this type of a machine. It should not exceed how much I told you, 200 amps or the thing. So we know that the machine cannot go beyond this 200 amps. So this 215 is cancelled. So 215 was the case for the wave winding. So no wave winding. Lap winding is less than 200 amps, so lap winding is okay considered. And the current per brush arm is like this 2IA by P, the armature winding specified as lap wound machine. Now the number of conductors, Z we need. So easily we can get ZE is equal to 5P and Z by 60A. Now we know A is what? A is lap. So in lap, number of armature paths would be equal to number of poles. So this would be equal to number of poles. Again, you have E into A, phi and P. So this thing Z you need. So you have the value of E. Okay, you have the value of A. You have the value of N. You have the number of poles, but you are not having the value of flux. Flux value, how do you get? You will substitute B average value you have. In that, B average is P phi by pi DL. So phi you can get BAB, pi DL into P. So BAV value you have 0.5, pi value is there, D value, L value calculated, 4 value, so you get the value of flux. Once you get the value of flux, you substitute this value here, flux, and the N value is there, that is N by 60, your number of poles is there, your E value and your A value is there, 4, so you can substitute here. So you get the value of Z in terms of fraction and take the nearest integer. That is an even multiple, not the odd one that you have to consider. So Z would be around 228 conductors. Now you have to go for the number of armature slots, time and again in induction machine. Again, we saw the number of armature slots is given by pi D by SA. Now slot pitch varies between 225 to 35. Why? Because 500 kilowatt. So depending upon the type of the machine, 55 kilowatt. So it is less only. In the previous section we have seen, so the range would be pi D by SA. So you have the value of VSA for 25, you will check. This is pi D by SA. SA is 25 and 10 power minus 3. Again, SA is what? SA is the pi D by the length. If you are keeping 25, so here 25 millimeter, 25 and 10 power minus 3, and this is pi and D value you have calculated. For this, it comes around 4.46, that is near to 45. For 35 mm, it comes around 32. So one thing we got clear, the number of slots is lying between 32 to 45. It cannot be less than 32 and it cannot be more than 45. So in lap winding, number of slots per pole should be multiple of pole pair. So allowable combination, if we are starting with 32, it can be either 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42 or 44. So one thing is there, it cannot be 45, it is only up to 44 because of the pole pair, as 45 is an odd number. So to reduce the flux pulsation, the slot per pole should be an odd integer of plus and half. So now the slots per pole should be taken as around 9 in order to prevent sparking commutation. So number of slots per pole is 9 or plus minus of half. That is either it will be 8.5 or it can be 9.5. So let us choose 9.5. So number of slots, if we have slots per pole, we are choosing 9.5. And since it's a lap winding, so into number of poles, so you get 9.5 into 4. So number of armature slots will get 38. So the design value of 38 slots in one of the allowed choice. So again, let's suppose your ZS, you need to calculate. ZS is equal to number of armature conductors divided by number of slots. So 228 by 38, some fraction, you will get the nearest integer value, you will get is 6 conductors per slot. Now for double layer winding, ZS should be even. So now one important factor, the minimum number of coils which is required, EP by 15. So EP is how much? 114. P is number of poles, 4, 15. So it is 30. Again, the number of coils which we studied lastly is half times USA. So U is the coil slides per slot. So U is 2 or 4. So it would be half into 2 into 38. Either it is 38 or it is 76. Now choose the number of coils such that conductor per slot is divisible by coil sides per plot. So this ratio you obtain is 6 by 2 or 6 by 4. You can clearly see none of them is divisible. 6 by 4 is not divisible, whereas 6 by 2, you will get the value 3. So U is equal to 2, we can expect, because it can be divided. And therefore, the best choice of the number of coils is 38. So the number of coil per this thing is 228, 2 into 38, that is 3. So we get the answer, main dimensions D and L we saw. Machine is using the lap winding. The number of conductors is 228 and this is 38. So this is about the problem. So first we have to see what we want. So this is how a problem is done. How many of you are not following? Tell me, please. I'll explain what part you are not following. Followed everything? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Fakresh, any part you are not following? Tell me, conclude the class then. If you are having doubts, please tell me.
No doubt, sir.
Anywhere? Some doubt would be there, na? No doubt, huh? So I'll take that and I'll stop recording.
No, sir.
So you're not, yes, okay, sir. I'll stop recording here. Okay, I'll stop recording. So you're not having any doubt.